Hey guys, welcome to episode 13 of Brilliant Botany. Today I'm going to introduce you to some really cool plant-pollinator relationships. Pollination in its most basic form is the transfer of pollen from one flower's anther, the male reproductive portion of the plant, to a flower's stigma, the female reproductive portion. Hopefully this results in fertilization so that flower can produce seeds and then reproduce. Self-pollination can happen within the same flower or within the same plant, or pollination can also happen between different plants of the same species. There are lots of ways pollination can happen: wind, rain, or with the help of pollinators. Pollinators are essentially shuttles that move pollen between different flowers. When I mention pollinators, you probably think of bees, and you would be right. Bees are really important pollinators, especially when it comes to agriculture. Almonds, for example, are the top export out of California at over $1 billion per year. Almond trees, of course, need pollinators, and that's where bees come in. Every year, hundreds of thousands of beehives are brought into California to fertilize that year's almond crop. So that means we need a thriving beekeeping industry to keep the almond crop going, let alone the tons of pollinator-reliant crops that we eat every day. Bees, however, are not the only pollinators out there. Lots of insects, animals, and even birds function as plant pollinators across the world. The ruffed lemur in Madagascar pollinates the traveler's palm. This tree produces large amounts of pollen that the lemur feeds on, and it transfers them between trees when it sticks its face in the flowers. Bats can also function as pollinators when they feed on nectar with their long tongues. These guys feed at night, and flowers draw them in by producing a fermenting fruit smell and producing large amounts of nectar. Like the lemur, when the bat sticks its face in the flower, pollen gets stuck to it and it transfers it between flowers. Sometimes humans have to be pollinators. Commercially grown vanilla has no natural pollinators, so every single one has to be hand-pollinated. Vanilla is an orchid and has a really small window of when it can be pollinated, less than 12 hours. So when that happens, growers have to come in with a piece of wood or a small piece of grass to self-pollinate that flower so that it will produce a vanilla bean. Orchids in general are really cool when it comes to pollination, and they've evolved some really crazy plant-pollinator relationships. Several species of orchids have grown to look like female wasps, so male wasps will try to mate with them. In the process, they get covered in pollen and hopefully transfer it to another specimen of the same species. There are about as many plant-pollinator relationships as there are plants and pollinators, so if you have a favorite, please let me know about it in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and if you'd like more plant science content, you can check out www.brilliantbotany.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.